friend? Raise your hand. How would you feel without your best friend? You will feel lost, right? You will feel like you have no confidence and no one to be there in your success or your failure. Well, so many social issues are happening all at once. I sometimes feel like there is no safe place. An epidemic has bursted out affecting many teenagers. At some point, it also affected me. Many parents, teachers, and students, and other adults don't see this happening, and when they do, they think it's a way of growing up or that it's normal. This has been in the hideout for years, and we have to eliminate this. This is my seventh grade class, and I was 13 at the time that I was with them. I was bullied. So she did, and it got hacked. And she called one day. She called me. And she said, "Well, Marisela, your Facebook was hacked." And I was like, "Oh, okay." So I went to go check it, and a lot of things were written about me. And later on, the same girl who called me, she said, "I'm sorry, Marisela. I was the one who hacked it, and I was the one who wrote everything on it. I'm really sorry." Bullying actually followed me through freshman year. The new thing wasn't MySpace, it was Facebook. And I remember one night I was doing a project and I was on the computer and I just happened to be on Facebook. And one of my seventh grade bullies wrote a comment on my picture and started saying mean stuff about me. And I remember that one guy from Carver, his name is Juan Barrera, I don't know if he's here, he actually defended me and he told him to leave me alone. And it wasn't nice for a guy to. Did not just affect me, it affected many people. About 3.2 billion people, teenagers, kids are being bullied every day. One of my close friends that I've interviewed, she told me her story about bullying. And she also went through bullying for a whole year. Her name is Miriam, and she told me that everything that she enjoyed doing, it wouldn't mean nothing to her. Everything that she liked would mean nothing to her. She was just depressed all the time. She told me that one day, she would ask herself, what did I do wrong? Do I deserve this? Is it my fault? Make a stop. And many other victims of bullying would ask themselves these questions. And sometimes it would be like, well, it's my fault, and it's not. She told me that one day she was walking and she was already mad at something and her bullies were coming. And she said, well, I wanted to stand up for myself and I did. She said that was the last time she got bullied. And that's what all victims of bullying have to do. They have to stand up for themselves and just eliminate bullying. Bullying is linked to many negative outcomes like stress, mental health, depression, low self-esteem, and anxiety. 7 to 14% of people who go through bullying self-harm, and 20 to 45% have thoughts of suicide. Every 7 minutes, a child is being bullied. These are some statistics of people who are bullied. inside of school, in school grounds, on the bus, on the internet, or actually physical bullying. According to DoSomething.org, 80% of students who witness bullying don't do anything about it. And we have to do something about it, because if we don't do anything, the bullying will just keep going on and on and on, and it will never stop. Samira 17 from Alabama states, I understand what it's like to be bullied, and being a bully isn't fun either. I'm a bully because I feel as though I need to protect myself before anything happens. And I do feel bad about what I've said to people, and bullying has to stop. One out of four will be bullied, and one out of three will admit to being a bully. Bullying is violence, and it often leads to more violence. When bullies grow up, there's a chance of being imprisoned is higher. One out of four elementary school bullies will have a criminal record by the time they're 30. If bullying isn't attacked now, more violence will be on the streets, like deaths and homicides. Emily 14 from Maine says, my mom and dad don't care about bullying. They say it's a part of life. It hurts a lot to them. It hurts a lot. To them, it's a normal thing, a way of growing up. These are actually things that actual teenagers post on a page from their everyday experiences on bullying. And bystanders post on this page, bullies post on this page, and victims of bullying also post on this page. We need to raise awareness in our schools, because bullying usually begins in middle school and usually leads up to high school. Skilla Uglworthy was a former TEDx speaker. She spoke on the TEDx during the year 2012, and she spoke about nonviolence. One of the things that she said, and it really impacted me, was that anger was like gasoline. If you spray it around and somebody lights a match, then you got yourself an inferno. But if you put anger inside an engine, it could only drive you forward. If bullying is treated now, then chances are that criminal rates will lower, and this rare word of friendship will be reevaluated. I wish for bullying to be eliminated from our schools and internet sites. If we can eliminate bullying and stand up for ourselves, then we would only have reasons to look forward. Thank you.